हेलो, नमस्कार। हाउ आर यू? फाइन। टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक रिलेटेड टू करेंट अफेयर्स, दैट इज 103rd कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट दैट इज बीइंग रिसोर्टेड टू ओनली फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग 10% रिजर्वेशन टू द पर्सन बिलोंगिंग टू वीकर सेक्शन ऑफ द सोसाइटी from among the general category. Okay, so this amendment article, this amendment 103rd amendment basically is related to 10% reservation being provided to the economically weaker sections of citizen from among the general category. Okay, so now, what is this amendment? Now, this amendment is only talks about it. This amendment introduces 10% reservation. 10% reservation for economically weaker section of the society for their admission to the central government educational institutions and private educational institution, except for minority educational institution, because minority educational institutions are protected by the constitution itself under Article 31 of the Article 31 of the Constitution. So this 10% reservation is applicable only in central government run educational institutions and a private educational institution at central level. Whether that private educational institutions is being provided fund by the central government or not. Okay, but this 10% reservation is not applicable to any state. Means this 10% reservation cannot be imposed on the state. States are free. States are free to amend the criteria of identifying the basis of economically weaker sections of citizen. Okay, so this 10% reservation is only applicable in the central run educational institutions. Okay, so it introduces 10% reservation for economically weaker section of the citizen or society for admission to central government run educational institutions and private educational institution, except for minority educational institutions. Okay, and also for the employment in central government job. This 10% reservation is not applicable to the any state. Means states are free to provide 10% reservation in state job or not. But at the central level, there is a provision of providing 10% reservation to the EWS category, economically weaker section of society. Now, it was introduced, this law, this amendment was introduced by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. And this amendment sought to amend Article 15 of the Constitution and Article 16 of the Constitutions. Okay, this bill was passed by the Lok Sabha on 9th of January 2019 and by the Raj Sabha on 10th of January 2019. Okay, now this bill was assented to by the President on 12th of January 2019 and it was notified in the Gazette of India on 12th of January 2019. Okay, now this amendment came into force on 14th of January 2019 and this amendment was on this very occasion, Honorable Prime Minister of India, our Prime Minister, says that this is a landmark moment in the nation's history at that time. Now this amendment is still pending the Supreme Court, and later on at the last day of this month, Supreme Court finalized whether to provide 10% registration to the person belonging to general category, or you can say EWS category, or not. So first of all, we will see what is criteria of identifying EWS from among the general category. Okay, so the criteria fixed by government is this EWS criteria. First criteria is, if candidates or persons annual gross household income is up to 8 lakh, then he is not eligible, or he don't have right to claim the 10% reservation or 10% quota under EWS category. Means his total household or gross household income must be less than 8 lakh. Must be less than 8 lakh. Okay? Only then he will be eligible for reservation under EWS quota. Okay, then a person's or candidate's total household, total family income must be less than 8 lakh rupees. Now, government decided two heads as far as eligibility criteria. First criteria is income. First criteria is income, and second criteria is assets. So, we are just talking about income. So, total family income, total family income में क्या क्या आ जाता है? Income of parents, income of siblings. Just suppose I am a candidate from weaker section of the society, from general category, and I'm just demanding 10% reservation under this category. So, what should be the eligibility for me? My family income must not be more than 8 lakh rupees. Okay? Means my family, total family income will be, should be, or must be below 8 lakh rupees. So, here total family income means my income, my parents' income, my brother's income, or all family members. If I am married, then my wife's income also. If I have some children, then their income also. Theek hai? Total family income must be less than 8 lakh rupees. Okay? Now, all these income, what is the sources of all these income? Sources are salary, agricultural income, along with business. If I am professing some kind of profession, then profession, okay. And others. Okay, these are sources of family income: salary, agricultural income. Income comes from agriculture itself. If a candidate is doing some kind of business, or he is any professional, and others. So these are sources of income, and total family income must not be more than 8 lakh rupees. It means total family income must be below 8 lakh rupees. This was the income criteria. Okay, this was the income criteria. Now, second is asset. Second criteria is asset. Now these points are, first point was related to income. Now second point is, if the family that own over 5 acres of agricultural land is out of the purview of EWS quota, okay, it means that candidate's total agricultural land must not be more than 5 acres. It means his total agricultural land must be below 5 acres. Must be below 5 acres. Okay. Now other criteria is his residential house. His residential house must not be more than 1,000 square feet. Means where he is living with his family, his house, his total area of his house must not be more than 1,000 square feet. It means his total residential area must be less than 1,000 square feet. Okay. Now, other criteria is, if candidate has a plot 100 square yard in notified municipal area or over 200 square yard plot in non-notified municipal area, then he is not eligible to claim the benefit of reservation under EWS quota. So his residential flat where he is residing must not be more than 1,000 square feet. Means his residential flat area must be below 1,000 square feet. And if he is having a plot in notified municipal area, then that plot must be below 100 square yard. 100 square yard, if you change 100 square yard in square feet, then it will become 900 square feet. Okay. And if he is having a plot less than 200 square yard or 1800 square feet, below is 1800 square feet in non-notified municipal area, then he is eligible for reservation under EWS quota. Means to claim reservation under EWS quota, all these criteria, first, second, third, fourth, all these criteria must be fulfilled. Suppose a candidate is fulfilling only these three criteria and fourth criteria, and he is not fulfilling fourth criteria, then he cannot claim reservation under 10% EWS quota. Okay. So for a person to be eligible to claim reservation under EWS quota, he must fulfill all these criteria. Okay. Now, what is the provisions under 103 article, 103rd constitutional amendment? What is the provision there? It defines EWS category. Okay. It defines EWS category, which recently we have seen it. So, define the EWS category. What is the criteria of identifying EWS category from among the general category? Okay. So these were the criteria for identifying EWS, economically weaker section of citizen, from among the general category. Okay. General category में भी बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग हैं जिनको reservation की जरूरत है, या सोशल सिक्योरिटी नेट की जरूरत है, या जो भी गवर्नमेंट स्कीम है उनकी एक्सेसिबिलिटी की जरूरत है, उनको भी अपलिफ्टमेंट करने की जरूरत है. Okay, so that's why keeping all these points in the mind, the government has initiated the process of providing 10% reservation to the person, to the economically weaker section of the citizen from among the general category. So this is a good affirmative action taken by the government of India. Okay, now what is the provision, what this amendment has done? Okay, so it defined the EWS category and what is the criteria for identifying EWS from among the general category. This was the first point. Now second point, it added clause 6 to the article 15 of the constitution to empower the government to make a special provision for EWS among the citizen except those in the classes that already enjoy the benefit of reservation. Okay, it means clause 15(6) talks about or empower the government to make a special provision only for the EWS category from among EWS from among the general category. From among the general category only, not for OBC or ESC or ESTs. OBC and ESCST are excluded from the purview of this article. Okay, and also it allows the reservation in educational institutions, both public and private, whether aided or unaided, excluding those run by minority educational institution up to a maximum of 10%. Okay, so this article 15(6) of the constitution, which was introduced or added through 103rd amendment, talks about or empower the government to introduce or to make a special provision for the EWS of citizen except those in the classes except OBC, SC or AST. Okay, and also it allows the reservation in educational institutions, both public and private, whether aided or unaided, except minority educational institutions. Meet this 10% reservation. I have already told you that this 10% reservation is only applicable to the center run educational institution or central level ke jo bhi educational institutions hai wahi pe ye applicable hai. Okay, now this 103rd amendment also introduces a new article, added a new article in article 16. It also added a new clause to the article 16 to facilitate reservation for EWS category in public employment central level pe jo bhi government job hoga wahan pe 10% reservation ki baat karta hai. Kaun si article 16(6). Okay, now the state government are given authority to change the criteria, to change eligibility criteria and also extend further income limit. Means state government are free to modify the criteria that is propagated by the central government. Means 8 lakh rupees ka jo criteria central government ne fix kiya tha, state government can change it. State government may increase this level, this ceiling, or may decrease this ceiling. It's up to the state government. But any modification or any changes in eligibility criteria in identifying EWS will be applicable only that particular state. Okay, suppose you Uttar Pradesh government is decreasing this 8 lakh ceiling to suppose 5 lakh. Then this ceiling is only applicable in Uttar Pradesh, not in Bihar or Madhya Pradesh. Okay? Clear? Now, implementation of any state. Now, all the states like Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Delhi, Gujarat and so on, these states has adopted this amendment and they are and started providing 10% reservation to EWS, and also they have started providing EWS certificate to the poor people from among the general category, and they now I have already told you that states are free to modify the EWS criteria, and that if any modification is done in this criteria, then that criteria is only applicable in that particular state. Okay, so Kerala state represented a very different outlook as far as criteria for identifying EWS is concerned. So in July 2019 itself, Kerala cabinet has constitution a panel headed by a retired judge K.S. Sridharan Nair, and was appointed by the government to set the criteria for EWS in that Kerala state. And what was the outcome of this panel, or what this panel recommended, is in front of you. First point, candidate's annual family income should be less than 4 lakh per annum. Candidate's annual family income should be less than 4 lakh per annum. Okay. Now second point is, person's family must not hold more than 2.5 acre of land in panchayat area, means khetiyar bhumi, agricultural land. In panchayat area means gaon. Okay. So, person's family must not hold more than 2.5 acre of land in panchayat area, and 75 cent land in municipal area, and 50 cent in municipal corporation. Means what is the asset criteria? Income criteria is less than 4 lakh. Asset criteria is less than 4 lakh. Income criteria is less than 4 lakh. Now asset criteria is families must not hold more than 2.5 acre of land in panchayat area, and 75 cent of land in municipal area or municipality or nagarpalika, and less than 50 cent of land in municipal corporation. Okay, this is the criteria set by this committee. Cent is the unit of measurement that is being used in southern state like Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala, Goa, etc. Okay, so suppose in Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, or in, you can say, in northern state, unit of measurement is decimal, very smaller kadi, decimal, katha, biga, acre, like this. So then cent is the unit of measurement in Kerala state. So now third point that committee recommended or committee finalized is, person's family must not hold a house plot having an area of more than 20 cent in municipality or in nagarpalika, और मोर देन 15 सेंट इन म्यूनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन. ओके, तो म्यूनिसिपैलिटी में एरिया कितना होना चाहिए, प्लॉट, प्लॉट मतलब घर नहीं है, प्लॉट है, तो ये 20 सेंट से लेस होना चाहिए, 20 सेंट से क्या होना चाहिए, लेस होना चाहिए. और म्यूनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन में 15 सेंट से क्या होना चाहिए, लेस होना चाहिए, 15 सेंट से क्या होना चाहिए, लेस होना चाहिए. ओके, तो क्या ने गवर्नमेंट ने किया कि 20 सेंट से लेस होना चाहिए. इफ अ पर्सन क्लेमिंग रिजर्वेशन अंडर ईडब्ल्यूएस कोटा देन हिज प्लॉट मस्ट बी बिलो 20 सेंट इन म्यूनिसिपैलिटी एंड बिलो 15 सेंट इन म्यूनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन. ओके, दीज आर द क्राइटेरिया सेट बाई दिस पैनल इन केरल. सो केरल स्टेट given very good example. Suppose why Kerala state decreased this ceiling or changes from 8 lakh to 4 lakh. आपको पता है कि 8 lakh rupees annual income में इसकी दायरा थोड़ी सी हो जाएगी, बढ़ जाती है. ओके, सो इसमें मैक्सिमम पॉपुलेशन इसमें हो जाएंगे और वहाँ पे भी कंपटीशन काफ़ी स्ट्रांग हो जाएगा. तो जो उसमें जनरल कैटेगरी में जो पुअर लोग हैं, जिनके पास रिसोर्सेज नहीं है, जो अपने ही कैटेगरी के लोगों के साथ कम्पीट नहीं कर सकते, उनके लिए बहुत ही डिफिकल्ट हो जाएगा रिजर्वेशन लेना या उनके साथ कंपीट करना. सो कीपिंग दिस पॉइंट इन माइंड, वी कैन से दैट दिस इनकम लिमिट ऑफ बिलो 4 lakh rupees, आई थिंक दिस इज अ वेरी यूनिक लिमिट. एंड सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ऑल्सो शुड डिक्रीज दिस लिमिट सो दैट द बेनिफिट ऑफ रिजर्वेशन अंडर EWS रीचेज टू द only needy persons among the general category. Okay, now what is the background? In 2006 UPA government constituted a committee for to identify or for economically backward classes. In 2006 UPA government constituted a commission for economically backward classes, EBC, for economically backward classes. And this commission gave its report in July 2010. And that report, commission says that reservation cannot be provided on the basis of economic criteria. Although state can identify EWS, economically weaker section of the society, only for providing benefit of government's scheme so that these people can be uplifted. Okay, this commission was not in favor of providing reservation on the basis of economic criteria. Okay, first point. Now second point say that ki 50% ceiling cannot or mark 50% ceiling or mark in the landmark judgment of Indira Sahni case cannot be breached. So commission was not in favor of providing 10% reservation or any kind of reservation on the basis of economic criteria. Okay, but he said that state can identify economically weaker section of or EWS only for providing social security measure. Okay, now in 2015 government in parliament there was a member from among the BJP. He asked the government in a question, supplement question, that whether government is planning to provide reservation on the basis of economic criteria, the government reply was that the commission or government replied that the economically backward class commission, which gave its report in 2010, is not in favor of providing reservation on the basis of economic criteria, and also says that the 50% ceiling fixed by Honorable Supreme Court in a landmark judgment of Indra Sahni case cannot be breached. So, government says that for the time being, reservation cannot be provided. But in 2019, same government says that we are just providing reservation on economic basis on the basis of recommendation of economically backward class commission, which gave its report in 2010. But fundamentally, same government in 2015 says that this commission has not recommended to provide reservation on economic basis. But the same government in 2019 says that this commission has recommended to provide 10% or to provide reservation from among the general category on economic basis. Okay, so this was the stand of the government. And government accordingly amended the constitution, because earlier before this amendment was done, there was no provision in the constitution of India to provide reservation on the basis of or economic criteria. Okay, so to provide reservation on economic criteria, constitutional amendment was needed. Without amending the constitution, it was not possible for the government to give this legislation. Okay? When this legislation was passed by both houses of parliament, some NGOs or stakeholder filed PIL in the Supreme Court, in the Honorable Supreme Court, and the most important among them are Youth for Equality. This is an NGO, and there are other NGOs also, other stakeholders also, who have filed PIL in the Supreme Court challenging this bill or this amendment to the Constitution. They argue that the bill violates basic structure of the Constitution, which doesn't permit reservation based on economic criteria. Okay, first argument was that this amendment is violate the basic structure of the constitution, because in constitution there was no provision to provide reservation on the basis of economic criteria. Okay, now the next argument was that the previous Supreme Court judgment has fixed 50% upper limit. Reservation cannot be, or reservation, any kind of reservation cannot breach 50%, or any kind of reservation cannot be more than 50% of the total strength or total seat. But this amendment raises the total reservation quota up to 59.5%. How it come 59.5%? You know, OBC category 27%. SC category 15% and ST category 7.5%, and now 10% reservation. Now this 10% new reservation also, if you add all these percentage, then it will be figured at 59.5%. Earlier total reservation was 49.5%. 49.5%, but after adding 10%, this new reservation percentage, it become 59.5%. Okay, so they are saying that 50% reservation, 50% upper limit set by the Honorable Supreme Court has been breached by this amendment. That's why this is against the basic framework of the Constitution. Okay. Now the next point, in 9-judge bench decision, in the landmark judgment of 1992 Indira Saini case, the petition said that this amendment completely violates the constitutional norms. Obvious. In Indira Saini case, Supreme Court says that ki reservation cannot be provided. Reservation cannot be more than 50%. Okay? Reservation must be below 50%. Total reservation must be below 50%. First point. Second point, he said that, Supreme Court says that, ki reservation cannot be provided on economic criteria. But both these points are marked by the Honorable Supreme Court has been breached through this amendment. Okay? 50% limit also has been breached, and government is just providing 10% reservation on economic basis. Supreme Court said that reservation cannot be provided only on economic basis. Okay, but this 10% reservation is being provided only on economic basis. Okay, so these two points has been breached, which was marked by the Honorable Supreme Court. Okay, now, and that next argument is that the amendment failed to consider that Article 14 and 16 form the basic feature of equality. Yahan pe equality bhi breach ho gaya hai. Because earlier OBC, SC, ST category, these reservations were provided on community basis or on caste basis, along with socially and education, along with a social and educational backwardness. Yeah, you can say that these reservations has been provided on the basis of social and economic backwardness. Okay, but EWS category, people from EWS category are not socially and educationally backward. So on this basis, this is again the constitutional moral. Okay, so and that they have violated with doing away of the restraint that were imposed on the reservation policy, that is 50% ceiling limit and exclusion of the economic status as a sole criteria. Okay, now such an amendment has vulnerable and ought to be struck down. Okay, these were the, and further they said that exclusion of OBC out, suppose this remember this reservation of 10% is provided to EWS category only on the basis of economic criteria, and from the purview of this amendment OBC categories and SCST categories are out of purview of this amendment. So this point has been raised through this argument that now this is an overwhelming violation of the feature of equality incident in Article 15 of the Constitution, they said. Now on the basis of these argument, they said that this 103rd constitutional amendment should be struck down, and Supreme Court or Honorable Court should pass an stay order. But Supreme Court didn't pass an stay order, but ready to hear the case. Okay, in the first instance, Supreme Court bench declined to pass a stay order on the amendment but agree to hear the petition challenging the this amendment. And on 6th of August 2020, the court decided that a 5-member bench would hear this case. Okay. Now, what was the government position? How government defended this amendment in front of Honorable Supreme Court? On 31st July 2019, K.K. Venugopal defended the government's position before three judges bench of the Supreme Court and said that 103rd Amendment was necessitated to benefit the economically weaker section of the society, who were not covered within the existing scheme of reservation, which constitute a considerable large segment of the Indian population. Okay, this was the first point said by Honorable Attorney General, who is presenting the government's view. And he also said that Article 46 of Directive Principle of State Policy command the state or order the state to promote with special care educational and economic interest of the weaker section of the population and protect them from the social injustice. What article unhone 46 ka hawala diya to prove his point? He said that in Article 46 of the Constitution, this article command the state to promote with special care the educational and economic interest of the weaker section of the population and protect them from the social injustice, especially for scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. The country's higher education, and he also said that the country's higher educational system, private unaided educational institution play an important role in providing education to over this much crore of the student in various program. It is therefore essential that the socially and economically weaker section get access to these facility mandated in this constitution. Now, third point that he put before the bench declared that the court would reserve its order and decide whether refer to a matter to the constitution bench or not. The court declined to pass an stay order and 103rd constitutional amendment remained in force. Earlier I have told you that in August 2020 the case was referred to the 5-judge constitution bench. Earlier three judge constitution bench was hearing the case. Now in August 2020 this case was referred to the 5-judge constitutional bench for hearing. Now matter goes to 5-judge constitutional bench. Now the court was intrigued by the incomely. Court says that how you arrive at the eight lakh income limit, how you arrive at this figure? What is the basis of arriving at this figure? Have you done any study? Have you done any field work? On what ground, on what basis you have arrived at this much criteria? So government was unable to satisfy the question put by the Supreme Court. Okay. Supreme Court says that this is the limit marked on this limit 8 lakh criteria is used to eliminate claim layer, and now you are using 8 lakh criteria to include EWS. Okay. and ask them OBC category is socially and educationally backward. This is for OBC category. Criminal limit is 8 lakh rupees and this had been fixed by the government. But Supreme Court asked that this 8 lakh rupees ceiling was for OBC category and OBC category are socially and educationally backward. Therefore, had additional impediment to overcome, wouldn't it be arbitrary to provide same income limit for the both general as well as OBC or EWS and general category? So this kind of question was asked by the Honorable Supreme Court, but government didn't answer satisfactorily. So now those in general, Supreme Court says that those in general category to whom AWS quota is applicable do not suffer from social and educational backwardness, unlike those classified as OBC, that any, and also say that any reservation norm or for exclusion should be based on relevant data. Where is data? On which ground you have reached at this income limit, 8 lakh rupees? The bench want to know that whether this criteria for EWS were arrived at on any study. Kis hisab se, on which ground you arrived at this income limit? So these were the argument. Unhone bola ki this 8 lakh rupees was all uniform all over the India, but the purchasing power capacity for EWS, one from urban area and one from rural area, is very different. Okay, so you cannot impose the same income limit for all over India, whether urban or rural area. Okay, whether exercise, and also next point was that this criteria was not fixed, or whether you have done any exercise to drive exception, such as why the flat criteria doesn't differentiate between the metropolitan and not metropolitan. Suppose the value of flat in metropolitan cities is very relatively more higher than the same than the value of same amount of flat or plot in non-metropolitan area. Then at this point here, value of these plots 100 square yard in metro notified municipality and 200 yard in non-notified municipality. So suppose this is in urban and rural area. Okay, so in urban area the value of same land will be higher than the value of same land or same amount of land in rural area. So these are basic fundamental differences. Then how would you arrive at same income limit for all the population or all over the India for these two different peoples? The question by the government couldn't be answered satisfactorily. So government asked to reconsider the income criteria, and Honorable Supreme Court has given almost 4 weeks, you can say 1 month, to reconsider the criteria of identifying EWS under this amendment. Okay, dhyan mein rakhiyega, this amendment was not against the constitution, or is not define the constitutional framework. This is good. Now The court has given 4 weeks, and after that, government court will decide when government will file affidavit after 4 weeks, bringing a new criteria for identifying economically weaker section of the society. Then Supreme Court pass an order and continue the implementation of this amendment. It's up to Supreme Court. Okay, let's. Now, what is the drawback or demerit of this amendment? It discriminates EWS from other category by exclusion of OBC and ST/ST from the scope of economic reservation, because OBC and ST/ST got reservation only because of social and educational backwardness. But these EWS category people are getting reservation benefit only on economic basis. So OBC and ST/ST is out of the purview of economic getting reservation on economic basis. So this is discrimination, and that only those who are poor from general category would avail the benefit of this quota. And next point is, this is in violation of Article 14 of the Constitution. This is right to equality of the Constitution. Okay. Now, it breaches 50% total quota limit earmarked by the Honorable Supreme Court in landmark judgment of 1992 in Indira Sahni case. So these were the demerits. Now, no transparency in the criteria for identifying the economically weaker section EWS for the purpose of granting reservation. There is no transparency in fixing the criteria to identifying the EWS category. Okay. Now, way forward. Kya hona chahiye? Way forward. Now, being a UPSC student, we should keep these points in our mind, because this is a very important topic, this very debatable topic, and this point must be remembered, and this will be very useful while writing the answer. So first point should be, it should be provided only once and for limited period of time. Reservation should be provided only once and for the limited period of time, just like 10 years or 5 years, 7 years, 10 years or 15 years. Okay. Now, next point, government should try to evolve a mechanism to slowly do away with the system of reservation. Dheere dheere government ko reservation ka system khatam kar dena chahiye. Theek hai? Lekin aise hi na hi khatam karna chahiye. Now, third point, government should focus more and more on quality education that fulfill the required manpower of different industry across the sector of the economy. Government education pe, quality education pe focus karna chahiye, skill development pe focus karna chahiye. Jo bhi industrial sector hai, jo economy ki system hai, उसमें जिस हिसाब से मैन पावर की रिक्वायरमेंट है, उस टाइप की एजुकेशन देना चाहिए. ठीक है. नाउ, गवर्नमेंट शुड स्ट्राइव टू वर्क फॉर द अपलिफ्टमेंट ऑफ सोशली, एजुकेशनली एंड इकोनॉमिकली वीकर सेक्शन ऑफ द सोसाइटी थ्रू आउट विदाउट एनी फेवर. ओके. Now the next point, government should identify the criteria for EWS in such a way that only needy get the benefit of reservation. Okay. Now this was the whole idea about the 103rd amendment and providing 10% reservation to the people from general category or economically weaker sections from among the general category. Okay. So all these were the ideas which we have discussed here. Now, on the basis of this discussion, there is one question. Now, it is in conformity with the directive principle of state policy to provide reservation on the basis of the upliftment of economically weaker section of the society. It is in conformity with the directive principle of state policy to provide reservation on economic basis for the upliftment of economically weaker section of society. Critically evaluate the above statement. Now, very important question. You can write this in 150 word. Okay. Now, the next question. Whether reservation can be treated as poverty alleviation measures and those not well off belonging to socially advanced community can be given share of reservation? Means, whether reservation, now next question hai, whether reservation can be treated as a poverty alleviation measure and those not well off but belonging to socially advanced community can be given a share of the reservation? Now also this question is also important. So this you can write this question in 150 word. Okay. So these two questions are very important. You can write it for your mains. So I hope I would be able to, I do have been able to make you clear all the relevant points related to 103rd amendment or 10% reservation provided to the EWS category. Okay. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.